Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were talking about different templating engines like EJS, JED, Plug, Pug. JED and Pug are kind of similar, and then we have a handlebars. These are actually templating engines which Node.js can use to render the templates from server side, and they can also inject data while rendering, right? Because we want dynamic view where data will be coming from your database or from some other data source, right? And we'll be injecting that data in the template, and we are sending that template back to the client. So here we are just trying to showcase one simple example. This code is already written, so I will just explain you what all things we have to add in our project if we wanted to give a support of handlebars. So we have already talked about different view engines. One, we talked about EJS. Another is JED. Here we are talking about handlebars. So for handlebars, you have to require this. I mean, you have to install this Express handlebars, this particular module. Okay. After that, you have to set the path for the views and the view engine. So we got the Express instance here. We are setting app.set views, app.set view engine. App.set views is a directory where your all the views are kept. So you can see path.join. Inside a current working directory, there is a views folder. Inside that, I have all the required views. Like here we have array.hbs and index.hbs, right? And we have the layouts also for handlebar engine. Whenever the extension is hbs, default layout is this, and layout are kept inside view and layouts. Some basic settings to initialize the view engine. Okay, rest all things are same. Here we are just registering the body parser. So these are actually the middlewares. We are setting up the cookie parser, body parser, logger, so that whenever the request is going, we should be able to see the logging happening on the file. And here we are setting the Express static file path to the public folder, so you can get things from this public folder without going through the API routes. Okay, these are just error handling middlewares. Okay, and main thing is this route. Here we have already talked about there are different ways to respond to the client: response.json, response.send, response.render. Render is used whenever you wanted to render the template from the server side. So here we are rendering index.hbs, and we are passing some data also to that template. Condition is true, title is this, any error is this. So now if we see what this data is doing in the template, you can see the title and condition. I'm printing title here. So if you wanted to print that value, you have to use double curly braces. So title will be placed here, condition is true, so this condition is met, and we are iterating on some array. So handlebars, there is a proper documentation how to write handlebar templates when it comes to a dynamic data. Here we are looping onto this data, each in array as a key value, and we are just printing that. And this is how we are iterating on a, you can say, a list of array, list of data, using just for loop. So this is just like a handlebar way of writing a for loop. Okay, so you just do npm install npm run start on the root route, because we don't have any other routes. In the root route, we are able to, in this index.js, we are able to render this index.hbs file. And this is how we are actually rendering the server side templates to the client request. Okay, in this place, you can also use EJS or JED. These are the other two templating engines we can use.